Hi everybody. So today I'm going to be reviewing a study that looks at mapping the potency in medical cannabis versus recreational cannabis in dispensaries across the US. This is something I get asked all the time by journalists, by patients, by doctors. What's the difference between medical cannabis and recreational cannabis? And this is why I think the study is so interesting. So I'm just going to walk you guys through it. Basically, what they did is they looked at a bunch of dispensaries in four states. They looked at dispensaries in California, Colorado, New Mexico, and Washington, and then in five northeastern states, so on the other side of the country. And they actually reviewed a total of over 8,000 products and 653 dispensaries. So 653 locations, over 8,000 products. So it's quite a good sample size. And they really wanted to know, was the average concentration of the recreational strains, the recreational cannabis, different than the average THC concentration of the medical strains that were being sold and marketed to a medical audience? And what they found was actually they were similar. So the medical products and the recreational products were similar in their THC content. And if we look into here, looking into the details, we found that the average THC concentration advertised online in medical programs was similar to recreational programs. So in medical programs, the average was 19.2% THC, and in recreational programs, it was 21.5% THC. There was a slight increase in THC in the recreational products, but really not what they call statistically significant, meaning it didn't make a difference when they analyzed all the data. So what does this actually mean for people? Well, what these authors are saying is that they don't think that high THC cannabis is medically relevant for patients. It's not always the case. We do sometimes use high THC products in a medical context, but normally speaking, when I start a patient off on medical cannabis, we're starting with really low THC products and working our way up, especially if they're naive to cannabis. If I have someone who's been using cannabis on their own for many years and they've been using lots of THC, then we might start with more of a balanced product, depending on what they're trying to target. So it also depends on the patient, their symptoms, the pattern of their symptoms, and a lot of individual variation. That's why it's so nice in Canada, you know, you have so many products to choose from. And really what it comes down to is it's matching the cannabis medicine to the patient wherever you can. But really, I like to start with low THC, high CBD ratios and work my way up. The reason for that is people get less side effects, generally speaking, and many patients get a lot of really good benefit from many different symptoms when they just start out with the low THC products. So even though they found no big difference between the way that these products were marketed and the percentage of THC in both the strains on the medical market and the recreational market, I still encourage people who are just starting out with cannabis, try a high CBD, low THC strain first, especially if you're really super newbie. And hopefully this was helpful for you guys. Thank you very much.